This is David Osteen, pastor of Hope Bible Church in Jackson, Georgia, and I just want to make a quick video to let you know we are disabling the comments on our YouTube channel. And, you know, we're very thankful for those who watch the messages faithfully, and you leave good comments, you ask good Bible questions, and you can continue to do that. Just do it through our website, hopebiblechurchga.com. And we love the feedback and appreciate it, so I hope you'll continue to contact us. And I will continue the Q&A series. I've been dealing with a lot of questions lately in the first hour on Sunday here in our church, but I'm going to go back to dealing with more of them, just making videos here in my office. And so as the questions continue to come in, we'll continue to make the videos. And so, again, you know, we'll continue to put the messages on the channel. You can still contact us, but what's changed is we're disabling the comments, and that's for various reasons. You know, I tried to once a week at least check the comment section to see if there's any questions that have come in. Sometimes things fall between the cracks. I miss things, and some questions get put in spam, or they're held for review, and I miss them, find them later. And so it's just difficult to keep up with. But as I glance through the comments section, I often see a lot of junk. And I've had to block a number of users from commenting on the channel because of just the absolute junk they spout in their comments. And you know, it's not edifying. It's a problem. And I mean, there have been people who said awful things. I just can't believe the things they write. And so that, you know, that's a minority. That's only a small number compared to most of the people that comment. But still, it's a problem. And you know, there are people who promote false doctrine. They come on the channel and they're trying to lead people astray. And I just here today was looking at some comments, and there's a guy who does not believe salvation is by grace. He believes you are saved by works. And I can see him leading someone astray in his comments and someone starting to listen to him. And I just, you know, it's terrible. And I don't have time to keep up with all of that. So the simplest thing to do is just disable the comments. And, you know, I hate it for those of you who use it right. But again, you can still contact us through the website. And, you know, technology, it's a tool. It can be used for good or for evil. And we're going to continue to use it for good and put the messages online. But some of the negative aspects of it, we can combat that. And I'm just tired of false doctrine being promoted in the comment section. So the easiest thing to do is just cut it out altogether. And those people are not going to be able to influence anybody without the comment section. Because, I mean, in other words, the only way to contact us is now through the website. And, you know, that's an individual thing. So they can't be on there influencing others like that. Now, those of you who you watch faithfully, you know, you don't have a local church in your area that believes the King James Bible and teaches and preaches it rightly divided. You know, we care for you. You know, I'm sorry that you're in that situation. The good news is you're in the church, the body of Christ, and we have fellowship in the Lord, and we can use the tool of technology to stay in touch. And, you know, we'll pray for you, and thank you for praying for us. And so, you know, we're mindful of that. We're not forgetting you, and I'm sorry that we're disabling the comments, but we just think it's the best thing to do at this point. So I appreciate you understanding, and I hope you have a great evening.